On October 21, 2022, an international news article surfaced citing that Global Ports Holding GPH signed a memorandum of understanding with the government of St. Lucia to manage cruise port operations on the island for 30 years with the potential of a 10-year extension option. GPH plans to renovate the island's cruise port facilities as part of the agreement, including expanding the existing Berthing Point Seraphim, which will dock Oasis-class ships. It also aims to improve the retail experience for passengers by redeveloping the vendor's arcade and other facilities at Castries. In a November 2022 interview, President of the St. Lucia Craft and Dry Goods Vendors Association, Peter Ras Iper Isaac, said that the Vendors Association had not been consulted in relation to the plans for the vendors' arcade, and he remained concerned that plans were being made for the vendors without the stakeholders' involvement. Since then, however, Isaac and the rest of the association have met with a representative from Global Ports Holding, and having seen the plans himself, the president reveals that he is in agreement with the entity's proposal.
The GPH people, they called us into a meeting, the Vendors Association. Three of our members were there, the president, vice president, and also the treasurer, was at this meeting. We spoke with the point man there, Mr. Sean Matthew, and he gave us the whole inside, the plans, he gave us drawings and everything that in terms of their intention. Now, he made it abundantly clear to us that nothing has been really signed with the government, no agreement have been signed, apart from the memorandum of understanding, which is the intention to get into business with them. They have to go through the rigors of consulting with stakeholders in terms of stakeholders consultation, and that's where we came in terms of, because we are stakeholder, we right there will be affected, and he has to continue dealing with things like the DCA and the planning department and to get approvals and so on and so forth. And he said when that happens, then, you know, the project, probably the duration of it may be about 2 years.
Much ambiguity surrounding the project has been addressed, and the proposal favors growth for the vending fraternity and a more accommodating environment for which to ply the trade.
I am extremely comfortable with that. We were hearing things from both the Prime Minister and Mr. Healy, but we were not assured as to how these things would happen. We heard about boardwalk and all this type of talking. They heard about renovating and fix up the vendor's arcade, and we knew that the vendor's arcade cannot be fixed, repaired, or renovated. It could only be demolished and to build something new. And that is what both the Royal Caribbean International, RCI, wanted to do. They didn't want to renovate the vendor's arcade. They wanted to demolish the vendor's arcade and build something for us. So now you have the GPH. That's the same plan. They want to get us out here, build somewhere for us where we would be between La Place Carinage and the customs, I think, Shed 6. They would be demolishing Shed 6, and then they would put us in between there.
With the promise of more space, more security, and a more ideal location, vendors can look to maximize their earning capacity once GPH's project comes on stream.
They gave us the assurance that there will be more places for us than is here now, presently. The other assurance we have is that they would not increase the cost of the rental fee, irrespective to the upgrade and so on of the facility, that we won't have to carry things nowhere home, back and forth, and it wouldn't be open. It would be a place where you have a complete store and to do your business. And we're happy with that as well. We're happy that they will not demolish the arcade, and then we have nowhere to go. So then the burden would be upon them to say, well, where would we relocate the vendors before we demolish? They are saying that this thing would happen in phases, and as they build these structures, they would replace people, they would displace people. So if you want to say, as soon as they build 4 or 5 of these cubicles or whatever they're building for the vendors, vendors would be moved in that same manner. So in that same, 10 of them is built, 10 vendors going over. And the vendors arcade will not be tampered with until when they get everyone out of it, then they will do what you call the demolishing.
Isaac says he is satisfied that the interests of the vendors are being taken into consideration, as he eagerly anticipates further information surrounding the Global Ports Holding project. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.